Module 22 Terracotta Mural Ceramic.
Eminent artist and painter Georges Braque has rightly said, "The starting point of a picture for any painter is a matter of colors and form." I believe that the poetry of art, if that is what one may call it, is a matter of animating these forms and colors. In the making of terracotta mural, the first step is to take well prepared, kneaded a large lump of clay, and I start dividing the lump of clay into small pieces about 10 inches in length and 5 to 6 inches in thickness. Then I make a thick duff of clay and beat it with hands and turn it into a thick chapati like shape. I spread a thin layer of sawdust on the floor and place this thick chapati like clay shape on it. Then I take a wooden tool held by hand to tap and spread the clay evenly. Then I take a wooden float or gurmala and tap the surface of the clay. After that, I splatter some water on the clay and move the hand in circular position over the surface of the clay. Then this wooden float or gurmala is also made wet and I move it from one side to another, making the surface very smooth. After that, a wooden frame about 12 inches by 12 inches is placed on the clay and then presses into it. Extra clay on the sides of the wooden frame is removed. Now we have a square tile of clay. Then, wetting my hands, I smoothen the sides of the clay tile. Then, with the help of my right thumb, I create straight lines around the clay tile. Now, fistful of clay is taken and pressed in my hand, turning into a round shape. I then roll the clay on the ground and make a coil. This coil is about 1/2 inch in thickness, is pressed onto the side of the clay tile, shaping it properly with my fingers and thumb.
Another pipe-like clay coil is placed on the clay tile and pressed into background, fixing it over the surface. Use the finger and the thumb very gently. I place another two small coils of clay and mix it at the edges or joints. Keep on pressing the moistening the clay and mix it at the edges or joints. After joining the edges, I keep it for a while and start making a small roundish clay pot separately and fix the clay pot on the clay tile surface. According to eminent British author and speaker Ken Robinson, creativity is putting your imagination to work, and it's produced the most extraordinary results in human culture. According to Canadian journalist, author and speaker Malcolm Gladwell, the visionary starts with a clean sheet of paper and reimagines the world. An American poet and philosopher, Henry David Thoreau, has rightly said, "This world is but a canvas to our imagination." Then use some water to gently mix it with the ground. Mr. Piet Mondrian, an eminent Dutch artist, has already said, "The only problem in art is to achieve a balance between subjective and objective." Thank you.
and then I polish its surface with wet thumb. After kneading the other part of the clay properly, I take a small lump and beat it in my palm and then on the ground to turn it into a small round chapati-like shape. Then putting my fingers under this chapati-like shape, I raise the clay shape, turning it into a torso. Then I gently make two arms and chest by using small pieces of clay and round them well with my thumb and fingers, mixing them properly with the bust. More water is applied to smoothen the body shapes of the female figure. According to eminent American realist painter and printmaker Edward Hopper, no amount of skillful imagination can replace the essential element of imagination. Another lump of clay is kneaded and again press and beat it with my palm, making it into a round shape which is fixed at the lower end of the vest to show the dress of the lady. It is gently mixed with first portion with my thumb and first finger. The whole shape is smoothened and merged with the background. I am making the hollow shapes of this figure so that they are easily baked and are light in weight. Then in a similar manner, I make a hollow shape of the face of this female figure and gently fix it with the ground, merging all sides of the clay lump and turning it into an oval-like form. Then I use small pieces of clay to make the features of the face of the female figure, bold lips and a nose. According to eminent American naturalist, author and philosopher John Muir, the power of imagination makes us infinite. I then place a clay strip on the forehead of the female figure and merged it with the face, keeping my fingers under the hollow cavity so that it is not pressed into the ground. Then I gently make small depressions to show the eyes. An eminent American author, Napoleon Hill, has rightly said, "First comes thought, then organization of that thought into ideas and plans. Then transformation of those plans into reality. The beginning, as you will observe, is in your imagination." Eyeballs are added and pressed into the shape of the eye. According to legendary Italian painter Leonardo da Vinci, the painter has the universe in his mind and hand. I then make a thin strip of clay and drape the head of the female figure and shoulders with this orni or scarf. This clay lump comes down till the left side of the vest. More clay pieces are flattened by my palm. I place this piece of clay to cover the bust area till the vest of the female figure. Then it is gently merged with the body of the female figure and looks like a wrap of cloth. The urni or scarf I had fixed earlier is shaped into a flowing cloth. While adding more details, I make pieces of jewelry like jhumar and earrings in the shape of flowers and also add the hair bun. I have a small tool which while pressed and create the leaf motifs. This tool can be made of plaster of Paris. On the wrists, I make bangles. And position of the hands of the female figure holding the strings to churn the buttermilk. Then a few small pieces of clay are added on the left hand top side indicating tree and leaves. With the help of a sharp wooden tool or a knife, I draw the folds of the skirt. And with the same tool, ornamental motifs and frills of the urni or scarf are created. Then I made the fingers and bangles with the same wooden tool or knife. I make a curve-like line on the lips to show the female smiling. With quick touches of the tool, I make dotted lines to indicate head ornaments. More folds on the urni or scarf covering the breast area are added. Decorative lines are drawn on the earthen pot or pitcher using the knife. Some lines are added on the hair bun to indicate pleats.